master another war machine. War machine tactics with your buddy Cajun. Sorry, couldn't speak there for a second. I'll be taking Cygnar this match. I'll be playing against Khador. Strakhov versus Siege. Let's get started. We both decided to go with one jack builds, so we're very infantry heavy. I have 5 storm blades, 4 gun mages, 5 gun mages, and a grenadier. Siege is a caster in need of a lot of help right now. He's not where he needs to be in the transition from tabletop to tactics. But I like a challenge, so we are seeing what we can do with him anyway. Strakhov, on the other hand, is a very, very powerful caster currently. Instead of being able to increase movement speed on his guys, making charges against enemy models in his control area, it just gives the guys a speed boost so they can just charge whatever they want, wherever they want. Now, the problem with Siege's feat in translation is on tabletop, I want to say Breach halves armor per round for the first hit on each unit each round. Now what they've done here is they've gone with the armor system. So say this guy's armor 4, they can subtract 4 damage from being hit. That's much different than say being armor 18 or armor 19. You know, where you may have a POW 15 hit attacking a Khador Jack that's armor 20 in tabletop when Siege feats that Khador Jack's essentially armor 10, so you're already up 5 damage just by hitting it with like a POW 15 attack. How Breach works in this is it just completely mitigates armor for one round for the first hit. So if I hit this big Khador Jack, it just won't reduce 5 damage from my attack, but that's the max it goes. I can't hit him harder than that, so it ends up leaving Tactic Siege with lower numbers of damage, and that is brutal in a game where everything is more robust. Warjacks don't have system damage, infantry have a lot more health, which leads to bad times for Siege. So they're looking at ways to bring his numbers more comparable to tabletop. A lot of people have given up on Siege for the moment. I just keep on trucking with him. I play all the casters, but I don't take Siege super serious right now. So if you're playing me and I'm Siege and you kick my butt, well, whoop-de-doo. But when he does get buffed, when the bugs are worked out and the factions are a little bit more balanced, I feel all this time I've spent playing through his weaknesses will give me extra knowledge and extra finesse when he's ready for competitive levels. I want to say right now the best casters currently have got to be Strakhov and Asphyxius. Those are probably the top two casters right now. Strakhov, because of the bug, he's gonna lose a lot of his luster for people, and he has to put himself more in harm's way. He's still got a great kit. I think I'm gonna play the heck out of Strakhov once he's fixed. Got a couple things working against him right now. Some of that will be fixed Tuesday. Currently, he doesn't have overrun. I don't know if that'll be on Tuesday. Sprint does not work yet, but that's supposed to work Tuesday. So, the 2nd, Tuesday the 2nd, depending on when I upload this video. So, September 2nd, the sprint should work, and that will increase his toolkit and what he can and can't do. His riot gun is currently bugged. Instead of doing a random number of shots, it only does one. I don't know if that'll get fixed Tuesday or not, but the ability to do the three ranged attacks will greatly increase his kit. And having those things working properly will really mitigate the nerf that fixing his ults will do. Right now, given the units in the game, these Iron Fang Pikes, they're really the end-all be-all. With such robust infantry, it's not such a big deal to take a free strike now and then. With those Iron Pikes, they have critical knockdowns. You can't chance a free strike, because if you get knocked down on your turn, you're screwed come the enemy's turn. It just really, really messes you up. With my storm blades here. He doesn't have a whole lot matched up against them on the side. Just some men of war off in the distance. What I really need to worry about is this little cadre of Iron Fangs. They are my highest priority right now. About my list is I don't really have any prime targets for him to lob his rockets at. Rockets are a great hit or answer to medium bases, whether that be a light jack, brawl, what have you. Their effect on medium bases is much the same as their effect on a small base, in that they knock down with a direct hit. Bit of damage. What the difference is, most of the medium bases tend to have a lower defense, such as incinerators, men of war, and rockets really let you control what the medium bases can do, like brawls. You know, if they're standing up, then they're not busy combo striking you. lot of warjack points. In tactics, you take the tabletop versions of your warcaster's war points, and you multiply that times 4. That's typically what your warcaster's got to spend on warjacks. So, Strakhov here has 24 warjack points, and he's spent 18 of them on a destroyer. Well, that leaves him with 6 unspent warjack points. He would have to dip into his main army's funding to actually afford a second Khador check. But it's hard to go wrong with a Juggernaut. With Strakhov's feet, with some of his support spells, such as superiority for Jax, Juggernaut really means business. Now, Siege only has 20 warjack points, and I left 2 on the table, as my defender cost 18. I wanted to be able to power the Jack up, not dip into my army points too much, and still be able to cast a spell or two, so I just really couldn't justify picking up a second Jack. I've been doing a lot of test games with Siege, and one of the biggest weaknesses I'm finding is infantry heavy lists, much like what we're facing here. Well, really extreme lists. Combined arms lists are manageable, but it can get dicey if your opponent's playing one Jack and a ton of infantry, or they're playing a lot of heavy Jacks. You have 3 heavy Jacks, depending on some of the siege builds I've used, you can be in a lot of problems. So, I find a lot of the problems get into in those lists is not having enough ranged assets to pick off what you need to pick off, or to manipulate the battlefield and control it the way you need to control it. So with having more gun mages, it's more thunderbolt shots, it's more knockdowns, more pushbacks, gives me a larger toolbox to control the field with. As far as target elimination, these storm blades are really my DPS. This is my defender here is for bringing people down on the way in, but once that line hits mine, the defender's one shot a turn is only going to do so much. Target the big heavy jacks too much, as he's got 34 boxes of health to tick through, and in the meantime all of these guys will be giving serious damage output. So I like to focus on what I can remove from the table. Thank you. I'm back. My son woke up from a very peaceful nap, and he was not very happy with it. gets the game. If he misses the majority of his attacks, I can salvage this. If he hits the majority of his attacks, it's game over. The dodges are really, dice are really gonna have to be against him to make him miss so much. He's gonna be looking at 63% chances to hit if he's not combined range, combined melee attacking. Go. Evades these gun mages provide me, the more they've paid for themselves. If I can do something in my next turn with my counter charge and actually eliminate these guys, we're in business. weathered that storm. The dice were very favorable to me. Let's hope that they continue to be favorable to me, and we'll see what we can accomplish. Solid damage from my storm blades there. Smoke's just lasting forever, huh? Guess that a long time ago. Essentially all of them. Strakhov had better learn the error of his ways and pull back. He really barely escaped taking half his health. Gunmage for MVP. The two of them should have combined together to make the attack, because, yeah, they're needing 14 on 3 dice. much damage in melee, but they rock socks in range for the most part. They didn't really get to shine this game. In part due to my failed attempt at a feat, and in part due to bad luck. Looking grim, going for caster kill. Wish me luck, internet people. 38% chance to finish the game if I get 11. Oh, got it. GG. GG. Thank you, internet people. Your prayers were answered. Yeah, overall, his army was just decimating mine. But you always gotta watch your caster. He's the only one that counts. Alright, guys. If you like this, like, favorite, subscribe, share, comment. Tell me which caster you'd like to see next, what faction you'd like to see next. I do take requests. Alright, thank you.